dear. This story's title is The Runaway Wok by Ying Chang Compestine, illustrated by Sebastian Serra.
One Chinese New Year Eve, a poor couple sent their son, Ming, to the market. "Trade these last few eggs for a bag of rice," said Mama Zhang. "Then we can make some stir-fried rice to share with the neighbors."
"It won't be much of a celebration again this year," Papa Zhang said with a sigh. "You'd think by working for Mr. Li, the richest man in Beijing, we'd have enough to invite everyone over for the New Year's feast?"
Ming hurried off, eager to do his mother's bidding. It saddened him to see his hard-working parents being cheated by the greedy Mr. Li. As he walked, he daydreamed about what a real feast would be like and how nice it would be to have just one new toy to share with his friends. A small old man stopped Ming near the market. "Hello, son. I see you have some eggs there. I will trade you this wok for them."
"No," said Ming. "I need rice. Besides, your wok is rusted and has no handle."
Just then, the wok sang out.
"Boy, boy, trade for me. I am more than what you see."
Ming had never heard a wok sing. He thought,
"This wok is magic. If it can sing, it must be able to do other amazing things."
So he made the trade. The old man sauntered off, chuckling happily to himself. Ming's mother wasn't happy. "Why did you trade for this battered old wok? What are we going to cook in it?" Before Ming could answer, the wok sang out,
"Mother, make me shine so bright and you shall have food to share tonight."
"See, Mama," said Ming, "it is a special wok."
"Let's do what it says," said Papa Zhang. "We're all hungry."
So Mama Zhang washed and polished the wok until it sparkled. Then she set it on the table. To their surprise, it rolled off the table and out of the door. "Where are you going?" cried Mama Zhang.
"Skippity-hoppity-ho, to the rich man's wife I go,"
sang the wok, and it brisked hopped down the road. The wok skipped all the way to the Li kitchen. Mrs. Li was overseeing the servants prepare the New Year's feast for her family. The Lees never shared their food with anyone. The wok plopped down on the counter.
"Where did this come from?" asked Mrs. Li.
No one knew.
"Well, put it to good use," she ordered. "It will make a nice serving bowl."
So the servants put in the wok festive stir-fried rice, pork dumplings, kung pao chicken, steamed buns, and walnut shrimp. There was still room for more. They added long life noodles, ginger fish, and rice cakes. Yet still, there was room for more.
"Keep filling it," commanded Mrs. Li. "I must go change for the party."
No sooner had the servant set the last bit of food in the wok than it jumped out of the window.
"Skippity-hoppity-ho, to the poor man's house I go,"
sang the wok as it trotted down the road, brimming with delicious food. The Zhang family could hardly believe their eyes. They gleefully removed the food and set up a big feast. As soon as it was empty, the wok rolled out of the courtyard.
"Where are you going?" cried Ming.
"Skippity-hoppity-ho, to the rich man's son I go,"
sang the wok as it galloped away. The wok caught up with the rich man's son Lan at the market, who, though he had many toys, he never shared them with other children. The wok blocked the road in front of him.
"What's this?" wondered Lan. "I could use it to hold all my goodies."
and without bothering to find the owner, the chubby boy grabbed the wok. Lan brought fireworks, toy dragons, cymbals and drums. He piled them into the wok, and there was still room for more. So he bought lanterns, yo-yos and kites. Finally, his weak arms grew tired and he headed home. When Lan arrived home, he put down the wok and he went to find his mother. No sooner had he turned his back than the wok hopped away.
Skippity-hoppity-ho, to the poor man's house I go.
It pranced all the way back to the Zhang's house with all the goodies safe inside. Ming bounced with joy as he emptied the wok.
There are enough toys here for all my friends, he exclaimed.
The wok rolled over to the door and out of the courtyard once again.
Where are you going? Called Mr. Zhang.
Skippity-hoppity-ho, to the rich man's house I go,
sang the wok as it spun down the road. The wok arrived at Mr. Li's shop just as he was counting the money he had cheated out of the poor people of Beijing. It leaped out through the window and landed on the counter in front of him.
Well, there is a nice pot to hold my money.
Mr. Li put handful after handful of gold coins into the wok, and there was still room for more. He dragged out a bag from under his counter and dumped all those coins into it too. No sooner had Mr. Li emptied the last of his coins into the wok than it jumped out of the window.
Skippity-hoppity-ho, to the poor man's house I go.
It scooted down the road all the way back to the Zhang's house with all the money safe inside. Ming and his parents danced with delight. They invited all the poor people in Beijing to their New Year's feast. Mother Zhang served the food, Father Zhang divided the coins up amongst the families, and Ming handed out the toys to all the children. In the middle of the party, without anyone noticing, the wok slid out of the door.
Skippity-hoppity-ho, to the rich man's house I go.
It hopped to the Li house where the father and mother and their spoiled son were weeping and wailing and blaming each other for their misfortune. When they saw the wok, they jumped up.
There's the wok that took all our food, cried Mrs. Li.
And my toys, whined the boy.
I'll break it for stealing our gold,
vowed Mr. Li. The wok sang out.
I dare you three to try and catch me.
The Li family chased after the wok. Chubby Lan couldn't make it very far without losing his breath, and Mrs. Li had trouble running in her fancy shoes. But Mr. Li finally caught up with it. To stop the wok, he jumped inside, pressing it to the ground.
Now I've got you,
he growled.
Wait for me, cried Mrs. Li.
I'll teach that wok a lesson.
Mr. Li tried to get up, but found that he was stuck tight. When Mrs. Li grabbed his legs to pull him out, she slipped into the wok too. Chubby Lan finally arrived out of breath.
Help! Help! Pull us out! Cried his parents.
Lan grabbed their legs up but lost his balance and fell inside with them.
Skippity-hoppity-ho, too far away I will go,
sang the wok as it tumbled down the road with the Li family inside, legs waving in the air. Dragon dances, drums boomed, cymbals crashed, and firecrackers banged, drowning out the Li family's cries. No one noticed as the wok sped off to the distant hills. The Li family was never seen again in Beijing. As for the Zhang family, they opened a shop selling woks of all different sizes and styles. Every year, they hosted a glorious New Year's feast for all of their friends and family. And to think that it had started with a rusted wok with no handle.
Thanks for watching. For more exciting read aloud stories, please subscribe to our channel Little Hearts Super Kids. Also follow us on Instagram for amazing updates.